the vision for this, you know, started with this concept of, as you know, when Glenn and I started MetalPay, we started building all this stuff, and we expanded and with the team, we created MetalPay, we created Nebula. We realized all of the wild inefficiencies of the banking system, card payment systems. It's just crazy that, you know, that we're typing, you know, our account and routing number into different apps, and it gives them full permission to pull any amount of money they want out of the system. And so we could imagine into the future where that at name, like at Jacob or at Marshall, could have that identity attested to it. So for example, you saw how you scan, you can scan that code to log in. You can try it out on protondemos.com with your Proton wallet. In the future, that can be a new login. So the whole create password, identify to a website, and it could be something as simple as Uber. In the future, when you go to websites and it's asking you for all this really sensitive information, do you want to A, type it all out? And B, do you even want to give it to them? What if you didn't have to give it to them? What if it was identifying for an app was as simple as checking out with Apple Pay, just a double tap on your phone, putting your face in front of the Face ID or touch on the Touch ID on Android. That's, you know, really the vision of where this is going. And, you know, the next steps for this are to have different financial services make these what I call access stations, which is basically a company like Metal or an identity service provider, financial services company saying, I verified you. I verified you, Marshall Hayner. I verified you, Carson Haloyan. You know, basically giving that what Fred calls the blue check mark, right? And that blue check mark is now lives on the blockchain. And now you can authenticate into different services without having to type out your SSN anymore, your date of birth, your address, all this information. And you may even opt to not give it to them. You may opt to only show to the, you know, the Hinge, the Tinder that, you know, you're a dating app. I'm not giving you my social security number, but I'm going to prove to you that I'm the real Marshall Hayner with one tap. Right? That's incredible. All this identity theft and data being stolen, that's incredible. And then, you know, the next step of it is what I was talking about earlier, what Glenn and I discovered, which is, you know, the banking system is crazy. And the card payment system is crazy. Why would we build such a system when, and Jacob said, what's his name? Is it Diffie or Hellman, the creator of public-private key cryptography? You know, what is it? What was that, like the 80s or the late 70s that they discovered public-private key cryptography? You know, this is such an amazing breakthrough that we can now give people access to things without giving them the password. It's really something that happened in the past, I think, what, like 40 years or something like that. And that capability is now going to allow us to evolve the banking system, evolve the card payment system. So, you know, the 16 digits on your credit debit card number, that is going to go away, and mark my words. And we've already seen the very beginning of it with the Apple credit card. The Apple credit card has no numbers on it. Why is that? Because it really shouldn't have to have any numbers on it. And I have, since the beginning of this company 5 years ago, equated it to giving out your email password. In the world of crypto, when we want to receive a transaction, we give people the public key. And this is very important. There's this concept of public and private key. So you saw earlier that that Jacob was showing you how to back up your private key. In crypto, for all blockchains that I'm aware of, they use public-private key cryptography. So when you create, you know, the equivalent of what is a username on Proton blockchain, you get this public key, like you saw, like at BackF or at Marshall or at Jacob, right, or at Saeed. And there's a private key that corresponds with it that you never give out. That's your password. And, you know, moving into the future technology, we're going to have an at name instead of a credit card or debit card bin. Instead of having, you know, a string of numbers across the front of the card and the back of the card that if compromised or a photo is taken of, all your money can drain out of this thing. Now it's just your name, right? It's like giving out your email address. It's totally safe. And it's funny to me because in the world of cryptocurrency, if I'm going to give you my MetalPay deposit address to put some metal into my MetalPay accounts, I'm going to go into MetalPay, I'm going to hit deposit, create a deposit account, and send you that address, right? But what I wouldn't do, and MetalPay doesn't have the capability to do this, but if I was using another crypto wallet for metal, what I wouldn't do is send you my private key. If I send you my private key, you can take money in and out of my account whenever you want. It's at your permission. And that's what we do in the world of banking. We give everyone our private key. Your credit card is like a private key. So the fact that we have solved this, you know, 40, 50 years ago, and then about 11 years ago, Bitcoin was created and the blockchain, you know, kind of revolution started to happen. We are at the very beginning, the very, you know, tip of the iceberg in terms of how this technology will revolutionize financial services. Because in the future, credit card fraud and debit card fraud and bank fraud is going to completely change. It's going to become a game of social engineering. And, you know, that sounds very scary, but it's going to become a completely different game where your credit cards are going to stop getting compromised every year. You're going to stop getting new credit cards in the mail, debit cards in the mail. When you sign up to new sites, it's going to be so easy. It's going to be one-tap login, this type of stuff. And all of this is going to be based around something like Proton, that can authenticate the stuff, that can attest your identity.